Dire Team Pick. Ten seconds remaining. Five seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Lock.
Radiant Team Ban. Ten seconds remaining. Five seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Ah.
Dire Team Ban. Dire Team Pick.
Legion Commander.
Radiant Team Pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Ten seconds remaining. Templar Assassin.
Thirty seconds to battle. The battle begins.
Look at it go! Not for you.
And gold are linked.
Give it up.
That should help. Arcanery. Look at it now!
You bastard.
Another head, another dead.
Nay, I say.
Wahoo!
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
A mysterious force.
I'm in your debt.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Finders, keepers.
Radiant's top tower is under attack. Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Go!
I'll take that.
Just what the doctor
Regeneration.
Ordered.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
What need have I for this?
Invoker.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
That stings.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
I'm free.
Here's a blade in your eye.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Radiant's structures are fortified. Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Roshan has fallen to the Radiant. Radiant's bottom tower has fallen. Dire's top tower is under attack. Dire's structures are fortified. Dire's middle tower is under attack. Dire's middle tower has fallen. Dire's top tower is under attack.
You almost had our secrets, so we could not let you live.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Finders, keepers. A golden thread.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
That should help.
Dire's structures are fortified. Dire's top tower is under attack. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Put me out of here.
To the loom with you, to be rewarded.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
And go
haste.
This will do nicely. I'll never yield.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Dire's top tower is under
attack.
Radiant's bottom tower has fallen. Dire's top tower has fallen. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
I'll take that. Regeneration.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Some things you can't plan for.
I'll have your skull for my satchel.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Remember?
Secretly, I admired you.
Feels good, man, to those watching in-game that has no sound. Whoopsie. I was wondering why my camera was not so smooth and stuff, but I guess I forgot to set up the in-game microphone and all that good stuff. It works now, though, so everything is jolly good. 18 minutes into the game. Nice one, nice one. Production value. Let's see, the Legion. Still no blade mill, still working towards it, but if he gets it around 20 minutes, it's not too bad. I mean, it's a Legion. It's a hero that is known for having maybe a good early game and then just like falling off completely. At least if you don't get a lot of dual kills, which he haven't. I mean, only 2 dual kills at the moment. Ivoga, still trying to finish his Aghanims. 1,000 gold to go, then that is done. In the meantime, they go for a movement. Beastmaster spawn. Not sure if that was actually spotting out that smoke, but they are moving out. They are trying to go for smoke initiation. The haste gets picked up by that Legion commander. Do they find an opening? Do they find a jump? They have the Sunstrike combo. They have the duel. And Orc is going to be the time they go in. They're playing their duel. The Sunstrike. They want to complete this kill. They need to get it. Oh, and they get it. Very, very close by. Was like, Milana, you're not... Oh, he actually used Fateball. I thought he didn't use Fateball. Just trying to, like, spite Nico and not give him the duel victory. But, well, they get the win. Very nice pickoff on Gorg. Not the most fun here on the side of Fort. I mean, he's pretty much in position 3 at the moment, as the Beastmaster is the big boy offlaner, and the TA, of course, is always going to be that heavy, heavy guy. I see the Beastmaster now picks up a blink, I'm sure. Yeah, that is a blink on the Coon. They try to go on the top and Focus Daughter will take the tier 1 tower down, and they will back themselves up very quickly, as they don't want to overextend, they don't want to be here when they're not welcome. In the meantime, wards are available. They could take them away. Okay, they will just drop a sentry ward. They will see the observer ward on the high ground as well, and that will be taken away too. There's a ward here in the bottom area in the meantime, so you could very soon see the Coon just go for utility use of the Necronomicon. He haven't used it for like a minute, maybe 1.5 minutes, and you need to keep using it, because it's like an ultimate, right? If you don't use it, it feels like you're wasting time, you're wasting the spells. And if you use it, you can walk around, you can deward places like this while you're farming, you can farm faster in the jungle as well, so it makes sense once in a while to use it for dewarding. His assassin gets jumped on duel by the Legion in the meantime, he gets killed, Pablo's dead. Alright, Focus Dota now gets a jump going on the Beastmaster. The Beastmaster tries to go for a TP away. He will survive, as this guy is way too tanky. He will get back to the base and be alive for now. They did lose 2 heroes though. The Weaver got killed as well as the Nyx Assassin. And now at No Logic Gaming, they go in, they try and spot out the Roshan action. They see him respawn and they're instantly like, okay boys, it just respawned, let's get the hell going and take Roshan. In the meantime, Excalibur, he does have vision of this, he knows it's happening. He may try and go for a steal if he's feeling cocky, but we'll see. Does Excalibur do it? Oh, he's gonna do it. He even wants to get the last hit as well, popping his refraction like that. Let's see if he gets it done. They want to contest very badly. They need to go in. They go in. They try and grab it, and they grab it. They get the last hit as well. They get the last hit and the Aegis on Excalibur. Excalibur's not trying to fight. So we'll set up on the Invoker. The Invoker will be taken down. Roar will be stolen by Milan. Very nice steal there, Milan. A little bit in trouble. He will be burned down by Excalibur. In the meantime, as that BKB got sent out right in time, he pops it, and he's going to be on the move, trying to find more kills. The Keeper of the Light is going to be the next one. As Hort, they find a bonus. J4, we dead on the side of No Logic Gaming. They lost that Radi. They lost the Aegis kill. They lost the Aegis as well. Excalibur still has that in his hand. So now Horde is going to be the ones going for a push. They almost took away the whole lead that Horde had, but giving away Roshan as well as the Aegis, that is not a good thing. No Logic Gaming is very much in trouble right now. As a Beastmaster, he did use his Necro Book, so he does not have that value available. They need to be careful with their vision, but they will take the tier 3 tower easily.
Dire's top tower has fallen.
Now they try and turn around. As Excalibur, he faked that back very nicely, but he didn't get the pop on Milan. He tried his very best though. And let's see, they continue going on that melee wreck. They force Rubik to use the shrine defensively. They want to burn this down as Excalibur goes for playing away. Breakers got used on him. He doesn't have a side base for a moment. He goes back in. Pablo tries to go for jump initiation. The Legion goes for a blade mill. Tries to burn Excalibur's first life. They will get the kill. They didn't get the duel victory though, I believe. Actually, they did get the duel victory. Now Excalibur gets the blink away. Will survive for the moment. Goes invisible. Manly got used on him. Focus Auto goes into that Shadow Dance mode. They need to help him. They need to keep him alive. Excalibur pops his BKB. turns around, keeps fighting. He's not done yet. The team may want to back up though. Sunfire comes out. Arke, oh, barely dodges that away. Bogutora, in the meantime, he's on the hunt. He wants to at least get something in return before someone dies. Arke, Pounce comes out. They dodge it. Necrobo gets used. Bogutora may be a little bit in trouble himself. Roar comes out as the Zog will be burned. Nyx's Assassin in the meantime goes in and gets a two-man spike. Carapace done off. The Legion burns. The J4 and the Cupid Fly will be the next one to fall. The Blinding Light does keep him safe for a moment longer. But no, the spike Carapace again. Pablo carapacing through the freezing, the frost so wall. Gaza gets control. Buyback comes out on the Rubik towards the Legion Commander. No Logic Gaming. They are in a lot of trouble though. Fortification comes out. Excalibur wants to get the melee racks, though he's not going to be done just yet. The case that takes a lot of from that melee creep. In the meantime, they jump in with the Legion Commander. They set up, they try the Sunstrike burn him. They get the dual victory. The Sunstrike missed because of the lift being relocated somewhere else. Slight communication issues, but either way, the Templar Assassin dies. They win the duel. They burn the Nyx. They burn the Witchstalker. And they get three kills. And they... Oh, boy. Fight that never ends, man. They got the Melorax in the side of Horde and ended up losing three heroes. So, all in all, they won a very, very huge fight. They forced buybacks on two heroes, I believe. Yeah, they forced two buybacks. They took a Melorax, they took a tier 3 tower so they can take shrines now as well. I think they're going to be very happy with what happened. Like, the Templar Assassin is still the most farmed hero. He is very close to finishing that Diffusal Blade. That is his next item, the Beastmaster. Alright, well, he's played well so far, ends up dying in the bottom lane, a little bit unfortunate. That is another, no, not a steal victory, just a kill. Beastmaster is now moving towards a Medallion Nexus. He has his Blink, he has his Tranquils, his Necro Book and all that good stuff, the Weaver. Then later, almost a Lingan Sphere completed as well. Looks like bottom tower is being pressured down, the tier 3 will fall. There's no Logic Gaming commit for more, the TA is now back up, they want to get the Melorax as well. Focus on it, will take Alacrity in his face. They will now back up though. In the meantime, looks like the Hemothali is in trouble. They BKB, they pop, the Legion Command tries to go for a duel with the Blade Mail, but it's not happening. He gets roared in the face. Milan now tries to TP out, but they have so much damage, they will burn him easily. Three is dead on No Logic Gaming, two of them without buybacks, the Rubik as well as the Legion. If they're fast enough, they could go for a push wherever the hell they want to hold. They're moving down the bottom lane. Looks like it's going to be the tier 1, the tier 2, and potentially a little bit more. We'll see. 40 seconds. 40 seconds, guys. Nyx Assassin, Blink is done on him, his Midas is done as well, and looks like his Academs is not going to be that far off. He needs 2,000 gold, so it will come online this game most likely. The Witch Doctor does pick up his Arcane Boots and his Urn in the meantime, so it's not like Arcane needs anything more. He's completely fine with the amount of items he has right now. And now Focus Dota goes in, gets hit by a stun, gets control. They continue controlling him. Do they have enough to burn him down? He does end up getting a Shadow Dance off, but he's taking a lot of damage. They need to just get a couple of hits off on some Focus Dota. Gets control, he goes invisible, he actually survives. He's healing, they don't have more detection. As Arke used all of his Sentuals prior to that, so Focus Dota will survive. Now he moves back in, he tries to go in. The sentries here though, Gorg, he is sitting under Sentry Watch. J4, we'll see him. Water Gem on J4 with that Academic Center being completed. So it looks like Gorg is going to be taken down. Duel comes out by Nikora, they get the duel victory. Alright, Necron. He's doing pretty well in the region. I mean, he's staying active, he's staying relevant in the game despite his net worth not really showing off that. He's working towards a BKB next. Let's see, the Key of Light does have that Ash completed with that gem on him. I'm not sure whether it disappeared, but I guess he just sent it back with the Curry, didn't want to use it maybe? Or gave it to someone else. I guess he gave it to the Slark, yeah. Slark has it. He does have a BKB as well, so he's ready to continue going for some big fights. Blink up on the Rubik and the Invoker, Axe. Almost a Lingan Sphere as well with his travels, his eels, all of that good stuff. Fusion is done on the Templar Assassin as well. He's moving towards a butterfly next. Beastmaster Solar Crest is done. Weaver. See? Axe still 1500 gold. Still 1500 gold. Bada boomch. Alright, we have a small pause, guys. Hopefully, it's not going to be too long, but we'll wait nonetheless. Alright guys, we are back. Game has resumed. Let's see. No Logic Gaming, they still have a while to go before they're completely back in the game, but they did fight a little bit back. They took down a tier 3 tower, so they can also be the ones taking down shrines. They actually have a Forge Spirit sitting up here just giving vision. I'm a little bit confused why. I mean, if you have a Forge Spirit here anyways, like, why don't you use the value and hit the shrine with it? It's like, you know, small things you can do that is annoying for Horde, because they don't want to just let a Forge Spirit casually take the shrine. They are now gathered up here at the top shrine. Looks like they want to take it down. They will have to trade, though, as the bottom shrine is being taken in the meantime. So both teams try and take shrines away from the enemy team. The top shrine is more important, though. The shrine next to the pit is always the most important one. So let's see what Horde decides to do in the meantime. They're still grouped up. They go for smoke. They want to move up towards the top area. And in the meantime, No Logic Gaming, they know what to do. They're pushing the top wave. Maybe they push one more wave and then they have to get the hell out. Unless they want to take a fight. As it should be fairly obvious, Horde is moving up towards the area. The courier will be spotted out. They don't want to pop it though. There's nothing in it, so it's not worth it. They probably just quickly checked. Like, they were like moving towards it. They probably like all clicked it and it's like, okay, it's empty, so it's not worth it. It's always nice to kill couriers, but you know, if you kill a courier and you don't find kills most likely. So let's see, No Logic Gaming. Fogasoda gets a jump on the Kun. The Kun gets control. He has his roar available. That Shadow Dance comes out in the meantime. Fogasoda will be pushed back. The Kun is still alive. He's being healed. He's sitting behind the wave target. And the Fogasoda still fighting up against it. Oh, nice block by Paolo. Blinking into his pounce. Fogasoda gets controlled. He gets killed. And the rest of the team got scavenged and killed by the rest. Weaver doing his thing, the Templar Assassin doing his thing. Meanwhile, the Slark was just trying his very best to kill the Beastmaster, but he's too much beef. The Solar Crest, the evasion, the tankiness, so much armor as well, and he was just moving around like he didn't care at all.
Cut from the same cloth.
Nothing, no damn shits were given that day, as the Slark, that was his 10-second BKB as well, and just felt like he was non-existent. Right now, the Slark's farm is also not so good. I mean, yeah, 12,000 net worth, same amount of net worth as the Weaver, but you have a TA who's 20,000, you have a Beastmaster ahead of you, you have even a Nyx Assassin who's sitting on a lot of net worth, so the Weaver not having the greatest amount of farm is not really a big issue, because the Templar Assassin, he's the real carry, and he's doing so much damage at the moment, and the Invoker, it's limited what you can do when there's BKBs on the enemy team, right? The Templar Assassin has BKB, they roll the Invoker every single time. He still doesn't have that Lincoln Sphere complete. I believe he just picked it up. So, and they can still pop the Lincolns and still get the roll on him. As long as they roll, okay, so there's no way that the Slark can take the fight on his own. The Nyx Assassin as well, gem on him. He picked up an Aghanim Scepter, so this guy is suddenly... this guy is pretty much sitting on the amount of farm you would expect him to be if he was offlane, so having a position 4 Nyx with this kind of farm is insane. This will do. Oh, I guess having an offlaner with this amount of farm where you have a Nyx Assassin who's greedy is also insane. You can say it both ways, I suppose. We have picked up a Lincoln Sphere for himself up now as well, so makes it easier to survive. The duel is going to be slightly harder to get off. He doesn't have any way to pop the Lincolns himself, so he relies on someone else doing it for him. Witch Doctor? Well, he's still actually, like, he's been able to buy those arcanes for, like, a long time, but it just feels like he never wants to buy them. I'm not sure why. I guess he's like, okay, I need more wards, I need more wards, I need more wards. Either way, Horde in the meantime, they pick up the Aegis, give themselves that. They have the cheese on, let's see, the cheese is on the Nyx Assassin, the Aegis is on the Weaver. Makes sense. Maybe you would want to give the TA an Aegis, but he has 6 items anyways. He has a Lincoln Sphere, he has a BKB, he has a lot of defensive items. So he feels like he's a god, he feels like he's unkillable. The Weaver can be the one on the high ground pushing the tower. And the Nyx Assassin is like the value cheese, right? If you're borrowed and you have a cheese available, you need to burn through 4,000 to 5,000 HP where you have that, what, 50% damage reduction or something like that? 40% damage reduction, so you need to do a lot of damage. You need to do, like, what, 7,000 damage to kill him in that situation? Pablo goes in, tries to go and focus on it. He does have that gem on him, so he sees this guy. Not happening though. The Slark has already left the building. Focus Dota, he is going the other way. Gorg, in the meantime, we'll see him. He realizes he is here. And let's see, he may continue chasing him, but nah, he doesn't feel safe. Alright, let's see. Keep going. The Beastmaster will be the one with the gem. The Nyx Assassin does have another gem, so they have 2 gems active. They took one away from the enemy. him obviously in the last fight, so using both is fine, because Nyx Assassin as well as Beastmaster, they are both like offlane-ish setup heroes, so it makes sense that you would want one on each in case the Beastmaster is like TPing to another lane trying to set up for kills. You don't want to not have a gem with the rest of the team, right? Oh, they take the tier 2 tower in the meantime, the tier 2 tower on the top lane will be taking down the TP back hero slowly. So no logic gaming, they need to defend this tower, but it's being pressured hard. Gorg does go in, he wants to do the damage necessary, does have that Aegis available, they will dodge the blast. Oh, and the Spike Carapace came out from the Nyx Assassin just to send that little blast back onto the Keeper of the Light just to be an asshole. Alright, they can go for another push if they want to. Another blast is coming out. Pablo, what a guy. Look at that Keeper. He's like, why do you do this to me, man? Like, what did I do to deserve this fate? Alright, let's see. Mid lane Slark. Maybe a little bit in trouble. Pablo, he's on the move with his gem available. He wants to be the one setting up on this guy. They see him go upwards. Focus Dodo goes invisible. He's moving up through the trees. They might be able to find him. Depends where they guess he's moving. And it looks like they guessed the wrong thing. They guess he was moving this way, but Focus Dodo, he's the other way. Alright, so he will once again force rotations from Horde without losing his life. In the meantime, though, Milan, did they have vision of him? I'm not quite sure. No logic gaming, they're moving over towards the Slark. We do have the Coop with an Invis rune available. He sees everything. He goes on Milan, he gets a jump on him, uses the roll. Milan does get purged, but it's not going to be good enough. He will lose his life regardless. In the meantime, Excalibur goes in, gets a jump on J4. J4 barely survives. Excalibur is going to be in trouble. The duel, the blade mill, so much damage reflected onto Excalibur as he will be taking down the Coop. In the meantime, needs to get himself away. They may lose a gem here. He does eat the cheese. He was the one with the cheese in the end as Pablo gave it back. Focus Dota takes a death wall to the face, has to get back himself up, he tries, but they dodge the pounce. Pablo's on the move, they have the gem, they have the vision, they burn the rest of his mana, and this Slark will die. Alright, so they killed the Rubik, they killed the Slark. Could have been a little bit worse for the side of Fort, but it ended up paying off, and in the meantime, the Weaver in the bottom lane, he was not part of that fight at all, like, he was just split pushing the bottom lane. Let's see, the Legion Commander does move in. There's a blade mill available, all of that good stuff. We will probably just continue pushing us. The Slark is dead for 50 seconds. Even without a TA, when you have Aegis, wouldn't you try and push? No? I guess they feel like the Invoker is enough of a threat to force them back. Alright, looks like that is a... I was gonna say maybe like a Bloodthorn being purchased, but no, he's like trolling me right now. He's only showing Crystallis, so it's like, oh, he's almost finished the Bloodthorn, but it's only a small part towards that Bloodthorn. He wants to go for Bloodthorn most likely, though. That is a very logical item against Invoker. And also just gives you a lot of right-click damage, so it's always a good item. And now let's see, Nico in the bottom lane will be set up on by Pablo. He gets the hit off, Gorg in the meantime. Nice Binding Light from J4 will keep Nikra alive. He tried to go in with a tornado as well. Pablo, he will be fine. Just barred up deep in the jungle so they don't get the kill. And this is a hero they may need to worry about. Like, MKB is very good against Coddle, but looks like the Weaver's content on building towards that Crystallis. He is banking up gold though, so he could easily change his build and go for an MKB instead. Beastmaster is working towards an Assault Crest, very close to finishing it as well as the Kuna, just getting so many items. Alright, let's see. Gorg just farming up, just farming and farming and farming. Excalibur, Lingens, Deso, Travels, everything is good to go for this guy. Having a lovely time. RK is now moving towards an Aghanim Scepter. He needs 2000 more gold to finish it. Kuhn, EC is moving out and is completed. I'm not sure if they want to wait for the next Roshan. That would be the safe play, right? But we'll see what they want to do. We'll see what they decide to do. Alright guys, sorry for that. Focus Dota is going to be the first one dropping down the side of No Logic Gaming. They did bring down Excalibur with the duel. Nico won the duel. Nico will be a little bit in trouble himself though. Pablo went in, got that impale off, and they get the kill on him as well as Slark. Equa on the Legion Commander and J-Force all dead. They did kill Excalibur once again, and there's no Aegis on the side of Horde, but this time they feel a little bit more confident. They want to at least force a buyback of either the Slark or the Legion. The Slark does not have buyback though, so this is going to be troublesome. And I'm not sure what the Slark, he actually dissembled his silver to get a Lingen Sphere. Didn't really help him out too much in the end. Gork, oh, he's dropping so low. He does have a time lapse available. Does use the time lapse. He needs to be careful. They're trying to earn him up with Arcane. Do they keep him alive? A Sunfrag stop doesn't actually kill him. He goes for time lapse. He's so, oh, but he time lapses into his death as he does drop down in the end. Milan will be a casualty on the side of No Logic Gaming, but they kill Gork. Also, very fancy move from Gork. In the meantime, Pablo, he's like, guys. Well, he's fine. They have no detection, so he's just sitting there. He's just enjoying it. In the meantime, top lane got pushed in, so they lost almost the range racks. Will be kept alive as Nikwa goes in and makes sure the range racks does not drop down at the very least. All right, not too bad, not too shabby. They kill the TA, they kill the Weaver. They once again survive. I'm just not sure what they're surviving for. I mean, the Invoker has insane amounts of farm. He will complete Shiva's Guard in a moment, but it feels like they need a lot more than that, and the gem guys. Yeah, okay, he will ping it. It feels like they need more than they have now. Like, they need more than a super farmed Invoker. He is not going to be enough. You can see there's four heroes on the side of Horde who is getting insane amounts of farm themselves. This Lark, he is so far behind on Focused Order. He needs a lot to be able to be relevant in this game. Like, you need the Basher, you need a Butterfly, you need a lot. Axe and Ghost of the Stun on the key with the light. He can pick up a blink as well, but it's like, you know, utility items, small survivability items, sure, but is it going to be enough to keep you alive? I don't know. The Legion Commander has his BKB completed now. Shadowblade got picked up and he's working towards an AC next. Would be a nice upgrade. The Rubik blink goes up there as well. He can move towards an Axe next. That would be a very nice way for him to enable himself to do some more plays on the map, especially considering there's a Nyx in the game, like stealing Mana Burn. I guess, well, it doesn't really matter with Axe, but just being able to steal, like, the Mana Burn, steal the Impale afterwards, steal the Mana Burn again, like, something like that would be very nice. Or just steal Mana Burn and use it repeatedly, I guess. That's also a way to do. Lotus Orb has been picked up by the Witch Doctor, so he didn't decide to go for the Axe in the end. Makes a lot of sense. Lotus Orb is great. Good against the mana leak from the Cube of the Light, the Blinding Light, and all that of that annoying stuff. Cold Snap. Now the Witch Doctor gets jumped on. Arcade, you do have a Lotus Orb, you have a Lotus Orb, you have a Lotus Orb, he's fine. Tornado comes out, but Kaiser doesn't get a kill so far. Rubik has been taken down in the meantime. Roar comes out onto J-Falls. Cube of the Light, the Cube of the Light gets taken down. The duel is won by the TA, so Legion does not take a no for an answer this time around. He will reflect enough damage to kill that Legion easily. And let's see, there's only two heroes left standing on the side of No Logic Gaming. They will back themselves up. In the meantime, Focus Order, he does survive, but they're on the hunt. Pablo, he's moving out. He wants to find something. He almost has an Octarine Core complete on this Nyx, as this is a lot of farm on the guy. He's just all over the place. Now he goes in. He tries to set up on the Invoker, hits the Spike Carapace, but he misses the Impale. Alright, well, I mean, Nyx is one of the heroes that even if it's a support Nyx, you could actually maybe kill the Invoker. That's how much this Nyx does against the Invoker in a game like this. Let's see, they got the Aegis again for themselves on the side of Horde. They have picked it up on the Weaver again. They go in with the TA, they burn down the J-Falls, keep the light dead for 30 seconds. Excalibur, BKB will end now. Kaiser, he needs to start killing, he needs to start doing his work. When he gets hit by an Impale, he gets stunned up. Spike Harvest comes up, he continues being controlled, he will burn. Invoker will be killed. He has to go for a buyback. Now comes the duel, but there's too many refraction charges. The refraction will keep the TA alive. As again, Nico jumps into that refraction, will lose the second duel because of that. I believe that's maybe even the third one. Focus Order tries to burn down Excalibur. Excalibur survives for a moment. Nice meld usage. Focus Order is not going to get hit. Lincoln's Spear gets popped. And that is a TA jump and two hits, one kill. Focus gets killed again. They killed the Invoker as well. So now it's going to be 4v4. The Nyx did die deep in the base. Metarize got taken down in the mid lane. In the meantime, Excalibur needs to continue going. Gork, let's try to burn down the range track. Fortification comes out. J4 gets jumped on by the TA almost kills him. Not quite good enough though. BKB gets popped. Milan will be the first casualty of the side of the Logic Team. They buyback the Nyx Assassin. They want to commit for this. GG gets called. as No Logic Gaming, even if you can defend the last bits of your base, you're playing against Mega Creeps, they rather want to take that chance in the second game, as this is game one, victory to Horde. Very well played, guys. And we'll see if No Logic Gaming can push back in the second game, or if it's going to be a quick and swift 2-0 victory for Horde. They played very, very well this game with their interesting Beastmaster and, you know, Nyx Assassin support. They changed it up a little bit, and it looked like No Logic Gaming were not quite ready for what happened in the draft. Like, I was even saying some different things than what actually happened. So I guess No Logic Gaming, maybe they're in the same boat as me, but we'll see.